Shake it, shake it.
When a person becomes a new parent, everything changes. All of a sudden, they have this new life that is completely dependent on them, and they have to figure it out.
Is baby hair loss normal?
Rosie is an AI-powered chatbot. Moms can ask any question about pregnancy or early parenting, and they can get a tailored response in the moment that just answers that question and then provide a source.
Hair loss in children can be caused by a number of issues, including hair pulling. I had a lot of anxiety, to be honest. You know, he's so delicate and you want to make sure that you're taking care of him. There's so much information on the internet and it's so hard to decipher.
Given all of the stress that new parents are going through, if you have something like Rosie, you're able to address a lot of it. The United States has really poor maternal and infant health outcomes compared to similarly developed nations. We also have very significant health disparities in maternal and child health in terms of race and ethnicity. Black women who become pregnant are at a 2 to 3 times greater likelihood of dying due to pregnancy-related complications compared to white women, regardless of income or education. And that's a completely preventable problem.
Our team is trying to provide a complement to the medical care that people are already receiving and addressing those disparities via health information. The idea for Rosie actually came about when I was a new mom. There are so many questions that you ask. What is the temperature at which your milk should be?
How do I give my baby a proper bath?
And how do I clean the bottle?
Is it okay for my baby to
be cold?
How
many layers should my baby wear? We want to have health information be accessible to everybody in an easy format, and it should be user-driven.
We're testing to see whether Rosie decreases symptoms of maternal anxiety and depression, whether or not Rosie reduces emergency room visits, and the final outcome we're looking at is attendance at well baby visits.
I've been wanting to get AWS to help serve some of the traffic during the outages. We use it as a time as like the update time,
yeah,
when
yeah.
There's like a backlog of updates that we want to push.
Our team has multiple components. There are the computer scientists who are building the app. There are the public health experts who are figuring out who's going to use the app. There are technology specialists who are making sure that people can get the app installed. And then there are statisticians trying to figure out whether we actually made a difference in these participants.
You know how when you're using something new, either it sticks with you or it doesn't.
One of the biggest challenges with Rosie is making sure that we give accurate answers to the questions. And as a result, we are grounding everything that we do in vetted, trustworthy information from a reliable source. One of the reasons I love this collaboration is that we have a process for collecting people who might be able to use the software, getting it in their hands, making sure they can use it, and then testing whether we actually made an impact.
So we're here today to be able to pack up some supplies for the moms who are in our randomized clinical trial of Rosie the chatbot. For every new mom who comes into the study who would like one, we give her a breast pump and also a strap to be able to hold the pump while she's pumping. Community engagement is a really important part of what we do in the Rosie the Chatbot study. So we spent several years asking moms whether or not a chatbot was even something that they wanted, and if they did want it, what might that look like?
So we currently have over 109 women in the clinical trial. We're hoping to enroll 400 women total. They're randomized half to the Rosie treatment group. They get access to the Rosie app and all the functionality with the Rosie app. Then there's the control group, and so they get a board book each month.
These are all of our books that we give out. All of the moms in our study are women of color, and so people should see themselves and their children in our books.
Oh, it's okay, come here. As soon as I got the app, I started shooting off questions. The Rosie app has like helped to alleviate a lot of the anxiety that I feel with having information overload. This also helped me to advocate for myself and for my son with going to my own postpartum appointments, but also going to his appointments. You know, these are some of the things that I'm noticing that the app has told me may or may not be a concern.
Our intention is to make Rosie as widely available as possible. The first step is making sure that she's effective and is impacting the outcomes in the way that we expect her to, and then we'll move into the more public distribution.
Look what you can do, look at that.
As a mother, this project is very important to me. Information could be power, information could be a resource that you could use. And then if we can just even help a few moms, I think that would already be success.